a QAnon shaman from Arizona, a firefighter from a small Florida city, a contractor with a history of financial troubles, a 70-year-old man. Participants in the riot at the U.S. Capitol on Wednesday came from many backgrounds and across the country with one common purpose: to protest what they saw as a stolen election. In social media posts and conversations with family, they staunchly support President Donald Trump. Help USA Today identify rioters who stormed the U.S. Capitol, though some conservative pundits, including Florida Representative Matt Gaetz, continue to blame members of Antifa. All of the people identified so far by USA Today who breached the U.S. Capitol or were arrested had professed their support for Trump through social media postings and conversations with family or friends. By Thursday, they had become America's most wanted, with the FBI, law enforcement agencies and the news media scrambling to identify the hundreds who invaded the federal building. Many rioters weren't shy about identifying themselves or why they were there. They snapped photos. They shared videos. They gave TV interviews. From a Baptist pastor in Missouri to a man convicted of attempted murder from Florida, all flaunted strong Trump allegiances. Thousands of protesters were in the nation's capital and participated in peaceful protests. But after Trump spoke for more than an hour to the crowd gathered for a rally, several hundred rushed the U.S. Capitol Police and invaded the historic building, scaling walls and rummaging around. Many were from small-town America. Some had legal or financial troubles. Some now find themselves in trouble with employers. Here's what we know about who they were. A photo of Richard Barnett lounging behind House Speaker Nancy Pelosi's desk with his feet kicked up flew around the world within hours. The 60-year-old Arkansas contractor, nicknamed Big O, bragged on camera outside the Capitol about how he was escorted out, but not arrested. He's a staunch Trump supporter known by Republicans in his community, and he attended a Stop the Steal rally in Northwest Arkansas in November. Self-employed, he runs businesses out of his home in Gravette, a small town of about 2,300. He has a long history of financial woes, including those brought on by COVID-19. As Trump continued to downplay the threats of the virus, Barnett also tapped a government relief program meant to help businesses struggling because of the pandemic. Barnett took out a $9,300 potentially forgivable loan in April from the Small Business Administration's Paycheck Protection Program, part of the CARES Act. He reported at the time that the stimulus funds would help save one job. Barnett also faced a federal IRS tax lien of $12,790 in May 2006 and an additional $3,876 tax lien in September 2012.